much of our attention, it seems, in accounting education is on how do you compute these ratios, where I wish we could instead focus on interpreting the ratios. You with me? Keep that in mind as we go through these. Okay, there's four primary categories of ratios. There's those that have to do with liquidity and efficiency, those have to do with solvency, those with profitability, and those have to do with market prospects. And some of these we actually addressed back in chapter 13. Do you remember when I had you do that connect assignment where you read those pages and you did that quick little connect assignment? Some of those were addressed back then. Let's talk about liquidity and efficiency. This is such an important set of ratios. Your current ratio, your acid test ratio. Remember those ratios? Those measure your ability to pay your debt in the short term. Your accounts receivable, your inventory turnover, those sort of things. Let's look through these. Okay? Again, short-term creditors like to focus on this when analyzing a company because this measures our ability to pay our debts in the short term. Remember the current ratio? Our ability to pay short-term debt? We do current assets divided by current liabilities, right? This is a very important ratio that I always compute for my clients, and we look at it over time to see if it's deteriorating. There is, and you can see how you just divide those numbers and you get some amount, okay? There's also the acid test ratio, which measures the same thing as the current ratio, that is the ability to pay short-term debt, but it does it in a little different way. It recognizes that not all current assets are equal, right? If you have $20,000 worth of cash as your only current asset, you are in a much better position to pay your short-term debt than somebody who has only $20,000 of current assets, but it's all in inventory. You see that? So the acid test says, no, we're only going to count in our numerator those what we call quick assets, those that are very liquid, such as cash, short-term investments, and receivables, okay? You can see the definition of quick assets down here, okay? Quick example of how this might be beneficial. We have three fictitious companies here, and I give you this information. Now, you folks at home, maybe you want to pause this real quick and calculate the current and acid test ratio, and then push play when you're done. But the current ratio and the acid test ratio lead us to different conclusions. As far as current ratio, company B has a healthier current ratio than A or C. However, a lot of their inventory or a lot of their current assets are inventory and prepaid expenses, which are not nearly as liquid as cash, right? So if you look at the acid test ratio, C, company C clearly has the superior ratio because they have a lot of their current assets in those liquid assets of cash, short-term investments, and receivables. Does that make sense? Okay. What about accounts receivable turnover? Okay, come off that for a second. Anybody here worked as a server in a restaurant? Okay, Jeremiah? Daniel has too. What you want to happen when you're in a restaurant is you want your table to turn over quickly, right? You want people to come in, you seat them, they order their food, you bring their food, they pay their bill, they tip you, and then they leave and somebody else comes and fills that spot. Did you ever have campers?
Yes, they're terrible.
That they come in, they eat, they pay, they maybe tip, and then they just sit there and talk about the Royals for 2 hours, and there's people at the door that want to sit at that table, but they're sitting there talking. Turnovers in football and basketball are bad things, but there's certain sorts of turnover that we want. We want our table at the restaurant to turn over so we can get more tips. We want our receivables to turn over. We want them to be collected quickly. We want our inventory to turn over. We want to buy inventory, it's sold, we have cash, we buy more inventory, it's sold, we have more cash. We want it to turn over like this. These next ratios up here, which I'm not going to read each computation because of time, but these measure those factors, accounts receivable turnover. How many days uncollected in sales do we have? How long is it taking our receivables to come in? Are our receivables slowing down? Inventory turnover. How many times does our inventory turn over in a year? what is our days sales in inventory? If we stopped purchasing inventory, how many days worth would we have to sell before we ran out? Okay? Very important.